Hey everyone, today we are going to check out ideograms image styles, and we're going to use the same prompt in order to compare all of them. There are around 18 different image styles in total, plus one lucky style, and then you can also select and combine in any order that you want. So let's go ahead and get started. And as you can see in the prompt, when you add an image category, there will be a comma at the end of your prompt, and then the name of the image category will be at the end. Now, when I look at these images, I would not say that they look like photos. Here's a closer look at the details. So I do think it's a great image, but it is not as photorealistic as I would like it to be or in comparison to Midjourney. This is the poster image style. This is the 3D render. I don't know, to me it looks almost pretty much the same as the photo. I do think that they did add a tiny bit more dimension in certain areas, but it pretty much looks like the same type of definition as in the photo image style. This is the typography image style. I'm a bit surprised that the first two did not have text, but at least this one does. But it did add an extra N, but that can be fixed in Photoshop. But I know most people want the words to be perfect right away, but you know, like I said, you get around 90% of the way there with AI tools. This is the cinematic image style. I mean, I think out of these four, this is probably the most interesting one. I think they did put a bit more emphasis on the background, which I like. So I guess that's a cinematic aspect to it. This is the painting image style. I mean, to be honest, the texture pretty much looks the same on all of them. This is the fashion image style. So I think with these, it's not just like the attempt at trying to make an outfit, but it created a full body pose. So that may be the one that you select as well when you're trying to get an image where you see the entire body, or at least half. This is the product image style. I think these image categories are also telling you if the image is going to be more in the foreground or in the background. The two that are in the background, they tend to have a larger composition to give the illusion that they're bigger. And then the two smaller ones look like they are in the foreground. This is the illustration image style. With this one, there is less texture than, for example, the first one with the photo, but they are very close, to be honest. There's not as much difference as I expected. This is the anime style. Right now, they're all looking pretty much the same. And this is the architecture style. So at least with this one, we see it's focusing on buildings in the background. So that's a good thing. This is the dark fantasy style. I guess with this one is more about isolation and drama, because as you can see in each one, it's focused more on the primary subject and it's trying to create depth. So I think it's trying to create a sense of intensity. So that may be something that you're looking for when you're trying to create your images. The vibrant image style. I do see that the saturation is slightly up. Well, at least in that first one. Slightly higher saturation. So two of them have a higher level of saturation. This third one has, with the orange, as you can see, it's Slightly, but it's still kind of a very dark, gloomy type of allure to the image. But you can easily fix that with saturation adjustments in any photo editing program. This is the graffiti style, so this one looks a bit more fun. He has glasses on, so I guess it has a bit of personality. That's pretty cool. I guess a bit more interesting. The background is different finally. He's happy. I guess I can say that. doesn't really have any graffiti elements to it. The portrait photography image style. So at least with this one, we can see that it's going to focus more on the face. This one's so funny. This is the wildlife photography image style. I don't see any wildlife, so I don't know what's going on with this one. I guess this is the wildlife bot. I wish there was actually more of these. That would have been kind of a funny twist to it, right? This is the conceptual art image style. Hope I get this name right. I think this is pronounced ukiyo-e. I'm not sure. My accent is kicking in. It's difficult for me to pronounce that one. But it is supposed to be like a Japanese art style. And this probably created the most interesting results. Well, at least these two. And for this last one, I used the Lucky Style image category where you are able to select multiple different image styles. So I selected photo, cinematic, 3D render, typography, and vibrant to see what would happen. So you definitely have to add, I think, a few different image styles to get something with more depth, a bit more interest. Yeah, you definitely have to adjust because I think most of them just by themselves, they pretty much look the same. So you have to focus more on if you want something in the foreground or the background, or how do you want the image adjusted slightly. I think right now, which is actually funny that I put on fine tune, they probably need to adjust the fine tuning just a little bit more. Because right now, they were so similar that even when they focus on like the foreground or the background characters, or even adding a few different styles, like for example, the cinematic color grading, it was pretty much close to the other one. So there wasn't as much of a difference between it. So I think if they improve that, that would be a great addition. I do think this is a great app and I can't wait to see how they grow and improve. And if you love AI, make sure to subscribe to my channel because I'm posting pretty much every single day. And I appreciate your time so much for spending it with me. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great night, guys. Bye-bye.